Good afternoon. My name is Ajori Spencer, and I have the privilege of supervising performing arts for Pinellas County Schools. It is my pleasure to welcome you to All County Music Fest 2022. Over the past several years and the life of the Pinellas County referendum, we have watched our instrumental All County groups grow from one middle school group and one high school group to two middle school bands and two high school bands. This growth would not happen without great teachers. As we begin this concert, I would like to bring up my colleagues who inspire the students that you will see performing today. Our band directors, let's bring them out. Thank you. This growth would also not happen without the support of our community and our generous sponsors. Pinellas County Music Educators Association, Truist Bank, the City of St. Petersburg, Pinellas Friends of Arts Education, the Robert S. and Mildred M. Boehnert Charitable Trust, Whitney H. Daly, attorney, and Pinellas County Schools. Without these extraordinary sponsors, we wouldn't be unable to perform three concerts in this magnificent hall. Words cannot express our gratitude for the support of our guardian angel sponsors. If you have not done so already, please take a moment to silence all cell phones. You will not want to miss a musical moment of these performances. Watch carefully to make sure the conductor's arms are completely down before you begin your thunderous applause. And this concert is being streamed and recorded by our colleagues in the Strategic Communications Department. It will be uploaded to the Pinellas County Schools YouTube channel and aired on WPDS TV 14 at a later date. The URL is listed in your program, which you may access by scanning the QR code on your flyer with your phone. We had a wonderful 11 a.m. middle school concert, and you are in for another extraordinary treat with our high schoolers. Our students have had the chance to work with some truly outstanding clinicians and conductors. Let's take a look at some of their wonderful behind-the-scenes work as they prepared for today's concert.
This event allows kids who may be the upper level of their program and are not used to a high level of musicality because their program just isn't there yet, to perform with kids who care about what they're doing, who practice, who work extremely hard, and then they play at an extremely high level. And it gives them an ability to understand what they can go and become, and then they go back to their programs and then they help push their program forward.
This year, I'm looking forward to really getting back into a full-sized ensemble, being able to play some music with some good players.
For some of these students, they have never been in a professional hall, and for them to sit on stage and see and hear what it's like, that hall at Mahaffey is designed to be acoustically perfect. When you watch them at the sound check, their eyes light up, their ears light up, because they're like, what is this sound? Well, this is what a professional hall sounds like. It's so much different than a band room. And it's an opportunity for them to experience something they will probably never get again, but they'll always remember.
The stage at the Mahaffey, it was just great. It was probably the best sound stage I've ever been on.
We try every year to get clinicians that are the top quality. This year we have two college band directors, one Dr. Wilson from FSU and Dr. Chipman from FAMU. And they give these kids a chance to see this is what music's like in college. It's not like high school. And these people are so full of knowledge that even us as directors, we get to watch them and learn just like the kids are. And so it's an opportunity for us to learn as well as the kids.
Always interesting to watch that process. My co-host for this afternoon will be Megan Alfaro, our current Pinellas County Music Educators Association president. Please welcome to the stage Mrs. Megan Alfaro.
It is a pleasure to be with you this afternoon. I am honored to introduce our first performing group. Our 910 All-County Concert Band is under the direction of Dr. Chandler Wilson. As you can see in your program, Dr. Wilson is the Assistant Director of Athletic Bands and Assistant Professor of Music Education at Florida State University. A native of Miami, Florida, Dr. Wilson is also an accomplished composer. We are excited to have a clinician of his caliber in the Tampa Bay area. Please join me in welcoming the 2022 910 Concert Band under the direction of Dr. Chandler Wilson.
Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon. Ah, we'll try that again. Good afternoon. Yes, they know that. I'm big on highs and things like that. Excited to be here in Pinellas County. Don't they sound fantastic? Yeah. It's been an extreme pleasure to be here. I definitely want to thank Pinellas County and all the directors for inviting me here to spend some time with their students, your children, for the last couple of days. It's been a fantastic journey. We've rehearsed really, really hard. They've pushed themselves. They've allowed me to push them. And I'm sure it's the same for the 11th and 12th grade group with Dr. Chipman as well. But tons of thanks to go around. I definitely want to make sure I thank Mr. Joe Cipiora from Boca Ciega High School, who is the director of bands there, who has been my personal liaison with this group, making sure we had everything that we needed. He's in rehearsal all the time. So students, can we thank Mr. Cipiora? Just go ahead and give him a round of applause. We're not going to ask him to come out, but we want to make sure we did that as well. Okay. I'm slightly tired, but the next piece is going to be even more tiring. Cool part about the next piece, slight change in the program, is a piece called Festival de la Noche, a piece that I composed, started maybe 10, 12 years ago. And they know the story. If you want to ask them, just ask them about a burrito, and they'll tell you the rest. But we actually started learning this piece on Thursday. So within less than 24 hours a day and honestly less than 3 hours of rehearsal, actually a little less than that, a little about an hour and a half, they were able to put on what you're about to hear. But thank you for being here. It's been an extreme pleasure, and I hope you guys enjoy Festival de la Noche. Thank you.
Thanks again to Dr. Wilson and the 910 Concert Band. Special thanks to Joseph Fiora from Boca Ciega High School. Mr. Cipiora is serving as our all-county coordinator. From planning seating auditions to working directly with all of our conductors, coordinating all-county is a tremendous amount of work, and Mr. Cipiora has done a superb job. Let's give him one more round of applause. And the good news is there's more. What you have just seen and heard are just some of our accomplished high school musicians. Soon you will hear more from our 11-12 group. Next Saturday, we will present both our All-County Orchestra concert and our All-County Chorus concert. As you can see, music is alive and well for Pinellas County Schools. On behalf of all of our students and teachers in Pinellas County, we thank you for being a tremendous support, and specifically for your support of the referendum. You are one of the major reasons that our programs are so strong. The good news is that being involved in school music is very beneficial for all students. Music students are not only more successful academically than their non-arts peers, but also students learn to work together in teams, to think creatively, and to learn about humanity and empathy. It goes without saying that strong school music programs would not exist without the tremendous support of our school board members, one exceptional superintendent, and supportive district and school administrators. It is the support of principals and assistant principals at school sites that ensures that arts education is thriving in our schools. At this concert, we have several leaders. I would like to ask any district leadership, any administrators, any board members to stand so that we could recognize you. Give us just a few moments to continue setting the stage, and we will continue our program with our 11-12 Symphonic Band. The process of preparing for these concerts is fascinating. When I attend rehearsals, I often think to myself, I wish I could bring the audience along with me to watch the process, which is just as impressive as the final product. As Symphonic Band members take the stage, let's take a look at the work that our musicians did to prepare for today.
County is basically the best of the best students in the county. And what I look forward to hearing is seeing the cream and the crop of our county perform.
Being in All County elevates my performance in the sense that it gives me new skills that I didn't know I had, such as blending with, you know, bigger bands or even smaller ensembles, especially within my own section. It teaches me how to lead or who to follow if I do need to.
Again, these students are the top, so they know about blend and balance. They know about articulation and dynamics and what is expected of them as a musician. And some of these are top leaders in their band, so they know what is expected of them from the conductor and from their peers also.
Being in All County is fun because I get to lead and I get to meet people I never knew existed in my county, basically. And it's so fun because the clinicians that come in are from all over and they're the best.
So this year, what is cool about All County is that we were able to have a piece, Danzone, with a piano part in it. So we selected one of our students, Miwash Gazier, an 11th grader here at PCCA, to perform. He's an excellent, excellent pianist, which is expected of all our kids, but one thing, he's autistic.
The way Miwash's brain is wired is that his mathematical part of the brain is more developed and working better. That's why the reading of the notes, and it's such a organized way for him. The music became a way of his communicating with others. Many times, people might not even know of his difference when he sits at the piano and performs. I am proud, but most importantly, I am happy for the community that this is happening, the inclusion is happening.
Just always thank you, always appreciative to parents who have the foresight to put their kids in the art and understand what the art does for our students here, because it is just an amazing art that we want all children to take part in on the secondary level, not just elementary, but in high school as well.
Let's give our band students just a moment or two to tune, and our program will continue.
Before I introduce our 1112 Symphonic Band, on behalf of the Pinellas County Music Educators Association, I want to offer my tremendous thanks to our all-county coordinators. As Mr. Spencer mentioned, Joseph Biora did an extraordinary job coordinating our concert band. We want to also recognize our symphonic band coordinator, Robert Thomas, band director at Gibbs High School. I have had the privilege of coordinating all county ensembles, and I know personally how hard this work can be. We are so grateful to Mr. Sipiora and Mr. Thomas. Our 1112 Symphonic Band is under the direction of Dr. Shelby Chipman. As director of bands at Florida A&M University, Dr. Chipman has accumulated numerous accolades, which you can read about in the program. Dr. Chipman is the current president of the Florida Music Education Association, and we are incredibly honored that he has been with us this week to work with our students and teachers. Please welcome the Pinellas County 1112 Symphonic Band under the direction of Dr. Shelby Chipman.
Good evening, everyone. All right, good to see you guys. I only have one thing to say, and I'll give my remarks after the next, please. Are you ready to dance? Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Wow. These students are so incredibly talented. Yes. You know, we do the curtain call so that the directors or conductors, as Mr. Wilson, I'm sure, alluded to, can catch our breath. COVID was not kind in that regard, sitting in the house all day. But let me first of all, ladies and gentlemen, say thank you, thank you, thank you for just a wonderful presentation. I think this is now my third opportunity here in the Pinellas area to present and conduct the All-County Band. I think I did the middle school band once, I did the 9-10 band, and now the good fortunes of conducting the 11-12th grade. And I don't take that for granted. I do not take it for granted. And I thank each and every one of you for this opportunity. I also like to echo what was said earlier in thanking all the music supervision here in the county and Ajori Spencer. He's taken over the helm, of course, for our very own FMEA representative, Ms. Jean Reynolds. And Jean is up in the measure section there. Please acknowledge our retired but still active music supervisor here in the county. I certainly want to thank Mr. Robert Thomas for being the session coordinator for this event. He's my former student and trumpet player in the FAMU band, and certainly he's doing great things here now at the Gibbs High School. If you would please acknowledge Mr. Thomas one more time, please, for me. Certainly would like to acknowledge all of the parents that are in attendance, any administrators that are here, principals, assistant principals, those persons that make a difference in the lives of these students on their various campuses here. So if you're a parent of any of the groups, 9, 10, 11, 12, or anybody that's performed, if you would please stand, and students in front of me and behind me, please acknowledge your parents and your circle of family of friends. Oh, that's not good enough. That's not good enough. Thank you. I just want to say to everybody, please keep music alive. As was mentioned, I am the Florida Music Education Association president, and again, honored to serve in that capacity. We have over 15,000 music teachers in the state of Florida from K through 21, and certainly the state of Florida is the largest music educators association in the country. There are a lot of states in this country, and we're very fortunate to have outstanding music teachers that provide guidance to your students. And I would encourage everybody to be aware of things that take place as it relates to the arts. Many of you I know are probably active with your communities as it relates to the arts, but we can't do enough and can't support the students on the elementary level all the way up to the high school level regarding the arts. Arts make a difference. And if I polled you and asked the question, how many of you sang in the choir or played in a band or also played a string instrument at some point in your lives, I'm sure a great percentage of you would raise your hands. And I know that that music, that opportunity that many of you have lasted with you for a lifetime. And that's partially why I'm sure your students and your kids are on this stage and involved in music. And so we thank you. Continue to be an advocate for music and for music education. Can we do that, everybody? And thank you. And lastly, to the students on stage, I cannot say enough about you. I get to go home and brag to the college students, sometimes they're 13th graders, and sometimes they're college students, about how we put together, yeah, that joke went a little late, some of you, a little late response. Okay, all right. And so I gotta stick to my five B's, and you know what they are, this is my third time here, be brief, brother, be brief. And I added a coda, sit down, after that. But I can't say enough to the students on stage, you guys are remarkable. You never know what we're going to, sometimes when you do these things, you never know the level of musicianship in the ensemble. And I know some of you are all staters, some of you have been in this group since middle school and high school, but you guys have risen beyond what I could have imagined. And I get to go home now and brag to the college students that if we did what we did in 9 hours, step it up, college students. So thank you for reminding me to send that message in Tallahassee. You are phenomenal. You are amazing, and I thank you. So the last piece that I always program And before I do that, I do want to say one quick thing. I want to acknowledge again Mr. Chandler Wilson, also one of my former students and now doing amazing things as a conductor and a composer and assistant director at Florida State. He commissioned a piece for Florida A&M University Wind Ensemble. And so I would be willing to speak with any directors that may be interested in that piece. But the title of the piece is Zenith. And it's a tribute, an honor to our former retired director of bands, Dr. Julian E. White. Some of you might know of him, may not, but he was director of bands. And he recently retired, of course, and we wanted to do something special. So I asked Chandler to commission a work for him. And so you'll be hearing about that piece. And if you may be interested, directors, you can let me know if you want to be a part of that project. The final selection, of course, is the United States Military Tribute Hymns. Of course, I always utilize this as a finale piece when I'm doing high school groups. And so I simply ask, once you hear the hymn of someone in your family or you who may have served, if you would please stand up at that time and we'll just keep the applause going and clapping to the end. The order of the hymns will be the Navy, Army, Air Force, Coast Guard, the Marines, and finally, God Bless America. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Bravo, and thank you to Dr. Chipman, our symphonic band, and to all of our student musicians, teachers, and clinicians. Let's give them another round of applause. How about one more round of applause for our concert band, which we heard earlier? As our concert concludes, we please ask that you remain seated as the students make their way back to the stage. They're going to collect their belongings, and then after they collect their belongings, they will actually meet you out in the lobby. Thank you for your support of music education, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. But first, let's take a selfie.